Hi, I'm Charlie Popeck, President of Green Ideas Sustainability Consultants. I was recently asked to write an article for an operations and maintenance magazine about some typical questions that facility managers have when considering a LEED EB program. And I wanted to share some of that information with you. So the first question is, what are the first steps facility managers should consider before embarking on a LEED for existing buildings, operations and maintenance initiative and going after the certification? Well, one of the first things is the facility manager and their staff should become educated about sustainable design, construction, operations and maintenance. A great way to learn is to become a LEED accredited professional with an operations and maintenance or O plus M specialty. This education will arm the facility manager with a thorough understanding of the LEED for existing buildings, operations and maintenance program, and it will make the project go a lot smoother, believe me. Now, from a project perspective, you should determine objectives for the project. There are several objectives that could be determined and identified early on, like energy and water savings, earning an Energy Star label for the building, maybe improved employee productivity, or public relations and outreach, or earning tax incentives for the project. There also may be some financial requirements the company has for the project, so we should think about those early, like any payback requirements or return on investment calculations that the financial department wants to know about. The ultimate goal is to use all of this information to define the owner's project requirements, or OPR, that is necessary for the LEED for existing buildings, operations, and maintenance program. Another thing you should think about is identifying the targeted LEED EB certification goal. You can target either certified, silver, gold, or platinum, and the preferred timing for earning certification. Timing and scheduling is very important with the LEED EB O&M project because it's all about the performance period. I'll talk a little bit more about the performance period later. At this point in time, it's also very cost effective and valuable to engage a knowledgeable LEED consultant for your project. You should look for a LEED consultant that has experience with not only the LEED EB O&M program, but also your particular project type. The consultant will help to develop a high-level certification strategy for your project, create an initial timeline for certification, which will, believe me, make the project go a lot smoother. The consultant should also coordinate and communicate the organization-wide sustainability initiatives and how they fit in with the mission of the organization in order to ensure a successful project. That's one of the first typical questions we get asked when project teams embark on a LEED O&M initiative.